Amen. God bless you, beloved. You are welcome to the second day of our Waymaker program in the mighty name of Jesus. We are welcome in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's begin to declare the name of our Lord Jesus, who is worthy to be praised. Let's begin to appreciate him for another time in his presence. Let us begin to appreciate him because he's God and he is a King of kings and a Lord of lords. He is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. He is the essence of days, the I am that I am. Let us begin to appreciate him, begin to appreciate God, begin to appreciate God. He is the Alpha, the Omega, is the beginning and the end, is the one that was, that is, and is to come. Father, Lord, we just want to thank you this hour. We bless you because of power belongs to you. We thank you for another day in your presence. We thank you for all that you have done for us yesterday, and we thank you for all that you do for us today. Father, Lord, even as we go into this program today, we pray that you magnify yourself in our life in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. Blessed be your holy name. Blessed be your holy name. Our Lord and our God, we pray that today you shall visit us in a different way in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty and wonderful name we have prayed. Amen. Beloved, let's begin to confess our sins, even as we ask God to forgive us and to cleanse us from all righteousness in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us begin to confess our sins and begin to ask God to forgive us and cleanse us from all righteousness. Father, Lord, we come before you this hour, even as we confess all our sins. We pray that you forgive us and hear our prayer today in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Father. Thank you, King of glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Beloved, let's begin to invite the Holy Spirit to take control of today's program. Let's begin to invite the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, to take control of this program in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, take control of our service today. Take control of our service today in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, take control of our service today in the name of Jesus. Take control. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Say heaven over today's program, open by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. The heaven over today's program, open by fire in the name of Jesus. The heaven over today's program, open by fire, open by fire, open by fire. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Say, oh God, arise. Oh God, arise. Visit me today, the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, arise and visit me today. Visit me today. Oh God, arise and visit me today. In Jesus' mighty and wonderful name we have prayed. Amen and amen. God bless you and enjoy the program in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Father.
in my life. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You have done it again.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the holy name. Adoration to Jesus. Adoration to Jesus. Adoration to Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the holy name. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the holy name. Adoration to you, Savior. Adoration to you, Savior. Adoration to you, Savior. People of God, God of heaven and earth, bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. The God that we serve on this mountain, the God that is faithful, the God that is wonderful, that God is awaiting us. And I know that you will never, never remain the same in the mighty name of Jesus. You are welcome to this second day of our revival program, The Way Maker. And I believe and I trust God that by the authority that is in the name of Jesus, this great God that we call upon, he will make a way for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Tonight, we are very, very privileged to have our Father in the Lord in the person of our Senior Regional Overseer, Pastor Adeyinka Adejobi from MFM Southwest 2 Mega Region Ibadan. He is going to bless us. Is going to connect us to the throne of God, and you will never remain the same. In Jesus' name, amen. Over to you, sir. God bless you, sir.
God bless you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. You are welcome to the second day of the second quarter revival program, and our theme is the Waymaker. I pray that the God that maketh way where there is no way, the mighty one of Israel, that reigneth in heaven and control the affairs of men on earth, he shall make way for you today in the name of Jesus. The God that make way for his children in the great sea, he will make way for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Whether your enemy like it or not, every stumbling block, every wall of Jericho, power assigned to stop you in your way of success, they shall be cleared away by fire in the name of Jesus. I bring greetings from my father in the Lord, Dr. D.K. Olukoya, and from MFM, Mega, MFM Southwest 2 Mega Region headquarters in Ibadan, Nigeria here. And I also want to thank my able friend, Pastor Ola Aturu, for this platform given to me to be a channel of blessing to myself and to others. And I pray that the Lord God that hear prayers and answer prayers shall answer all our prayers in the mighty name of Jesus. I want us to be expectant. I want us to believe God. I want us to know that we are serving a God that maketh way for his children. No matter what has happened in the past, no matter what people are saying, no matter what we are even passing through now, I want to assure you, because I'm convinced in the spirit, that before the end of this special program, the way maker, God shall lift you up. God shall promote you. God shall take you to your expected destination in the mighty name of Jesus. The title of the message that I want to talk briefly as we are going to pray, and I want you to prepare yourself to pray, is what I call God make a way for me. God make a way for me. God make a way for me. Let's close our eyes. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you for the life of your people. I thank you for as many that are connected to this broadcast. I thank you for your grace upon their life. I thank you for what you have done in the first day. I thank you for what you are going to do today. I thank you for what you are going to do to perfect all that you alone can do in the life of your people tomorrow. Father, I set our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. Oh God, that make it way where there's no way. I pray that before the end of this service, make way for your children in the name of Jesus. If there's any strong man of their father's house saying no to the yes of God in their life, today, O Lord, I pray, let such voice of the strong man be silenced forever in the name of Jesus. Move, O Lord, in an unusual way today. Do wonders. Heal the sick. Set the captive free. Make way even where there's no way. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Quickly, I want to read from my team, a text, Isaiah 43, 15, and 16. It says this, I am the Lord, your only one, the creator of Israel, your king. Thus said the Lord, verse 16, thus said the Lord, which maketh a way in the sea and a path in the mighty water. The God that maketh a way in the sea, the God that created paths for his people to pass through in the mighty water. The Spirit of the Lord says, I should tell you that that God is still available. That God is still in action of doing his work. And today, God will make way for you in the mighty name of Jesus. In Psalm 77, verse 19, the Bible says this, thy way is in the sea, and that path in the great waters, and that footstep are not known. God have his way everywhere, on the mountain, in the valley, in the sea, in the firmament, in the heavens, in the forest, in the wilderness, in the desert land. God have his way there. I don't know the problem you are facing now. The Spirit of Lord said, I should tell you, the God that make way for his people to escape from long time bondage in Egypt, he shall make way of escape for you in the mighty name of Jesus. In Isaiah 51, I want to read verse 10. It says this, art thou not it which had dried the Red Sea, the waters of the great deep that had made the depth of the sea a way for the ransom to pass over? Because you are an apple of the eye of God, you are one of his ransom, because he has purchased you with the blood of Jesus. So therefore, I speak the word of God into your life. And as many that are connected to this broadcast, God will surely make a way for you in the mighty name of Jesus. I say, God will surely make a way for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's close our eyes and take these three prayers before we continue. Shout this loud and clear. Oh God, my Father, you are the way maker. Make a way for me where there is no way, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, you are the mighty one of Israel, the way maker. Make a way for me where there is no way. Make a way for me where there's no way. Oh God, my Father, you are the way maker, Jesus. Pray the second one with more violence in your spirit. Oh God, my Father, open my eyes, show me your way. Oh God, my Father, open my eyes and show me your way. In the name of Jesus, oh God, my Father, open my eyes and show me your way. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Powers assigned to lead me in the wrong way, I bind them. I cast you out of my life. In the name of Jesus, powers assigned to lead me in the wrong way of life, I bound him and I cast you out of my life. Any power anywhere assigned to lead me in the wrong way of life, I bind him and cast you out of my life. I bind him and I cast you out of my life. I bind him and I cast you out of my life. I bind him and I cast you out of my life. In the name of Jesus, In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I want us to listen carefully. As the word of God shall be coming forth now, to be coming forth with power and fire that has the capacity to transform your life. There is power in the word of God. There is light in the word of God. And I decree now by the decree of heaven, as many that are connected to the broadcast, as you hear the word of God from my mouth, the light of God shall shine into your life and darkness shall disappear in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. The God that created the heaven and the earth is the God that maketh way, even where it seems there is no way. The God that dwelleth in heaven, the God that controls the affairs of men on earth, the God that no darkness can be hidden from him, is the God that maketh way where there is no way. And I say it again, by the spirit of prophecy, powers anywhere, any agent of darkness, blocking your way of advancement, your way of success, your way onto the top, I command them to catch fire in the name of Jesus. He maketh way for his people in the great sea. God led his people in the wilderness. He made water to flow like a river in the desert. There's nothing too hard for you to do. And I know that problem that have been making you to cry secretly, that have been making you to fold your hand and begin to look up, that when will the Lord remove this obstacle, remove this reproach out of my life, I pray for you today. Even before the end of this program, my little people, Italia, the God that maketh way where there's no way, he will make way for you. He will deliver you. He will set you free in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. God shows his people the way to go and he clear away every obstacle, every word of Jericho, and is ready to kill the giants that have stationed themselves in the way of his people. I don't know the problem at hand. I don't know, and I don't want to know the powers that be saying that there's no way for you. I don't want to know what the enemy has spoken into your life, and you can see it manifesting physically. I don't want to know the arrow of confusion that is prospering against you, even in foreign land. But I know a God, the mighty one of Israel, the man of war, the Lord of hosts, the God that is strong in battle, the God that maketh way for his people. I say into your life again, the Lord God shall make way for you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I don't want to know the messengers of darkness assigned to stop you suddenly, even where you are about to get to the top. What I know, that there is a God that make way for his people. The enemy thought that the prison of Egypt can capture the destiny of Joseph, but they did not know that there is a God that made way for his people. He opened the prison door, and the bar and the chains of darkness in that prison cannot hold the destiny of Joseph. I pray for you. If there is any physical or spiritual prison holding down your destiny, holding down your breakthrough, let that prison open now by fire in the name of Jesus. There is a God that makes way where there's no way. There is a God that opens the closed door for his people. There is a God that opens and that when he opens, no man can close both physical and spiritual gates of darkness. There is a God that make water to flow in the desert in order to satisfy his people in the wilderness. And he also rained down heavenly food for his people to eat. Not only that, he also fed them with flesh. I pray for you, where people say there is no way for you. When all hope are lost, I decree by the decree of heaven, the God that maketh way, even in the desert, the God that fed his people in the desert, suddenly it will appear in that situation of yours, and it shall make a way for you. As a God shall make a way for you, God shall make a way for you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. What you need to do is to connect to the God that maketh way. What you need to do is to join yourself to the God that maketh way, and it will surely surprise you. What is way? Way is the route, the path to take in order to arrive at one's destination. Do you know that at the end of every road, every there is a gate or door that the enemy wants to close against you? I pray for you now. Any power anywhere erecting evil gate in order to lock you up, not to get into your destination, I command that power together with the evil gate to be rooted out of your way in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In your way of life, your way of fulfillment, your way to fulfill your destiny, there are lots of problems, valley and hills, obstacles, hindrances, traps, and pit that the enemy has done. Giants to stop you in the way. The Spirit of God said, I should tell you, whatsoever thing they have put in place in order to hinder you, in order to delay you, in order to slow you down, in order to cast you down, or to stop you entirely, the Lord God that maketh way. Not only that, he also destroyed the enemy of his people, even along the way. He shall arise in his power and destroy them all, together with the instrument of hindrance, together with the instrument and obstacle that they have gathered together to stop him, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Job chapter 18, verse 10, the Bible says this: the snare is laid for him in the ground, and a trap for him in the way. The enemy, a wicked enemy, trap in the way. I'm praying for you again, in that way of your prosperity, in the way of your joy, in that way that God has made for you to receive from him, whatsoever thing assigned to cast you down, to stop you suddenly, in order not to receive from God, wherever they are operating from, I command them to catch fire now, in the name of Jesus. Pray this prayer as we continue. Every snare and trap assigned to hold me down in the way of my success, in the way of my breakthrough, catch fire now, in the name of Jesus. Catch fire now, 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 catch fire now. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Listen to this. In Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 10. Deuteronomy 32, verse 10. The Bible says this. He found him in a desert land, and in the waste holy wilderness, he led him about. He instructed him. He kept him as the apple of his eye. God found you when you are nothing, in a desert land where all hope is lost, where there is nothing to sustain life. If discover you in the wilderness, when you are nothing, and he led you about. He instructed me in order to keep you as the apple of his eye. He showed you the way to go. He guided you in the way to follow. I'm praying for you again. The Lord God that has been leading you all this while will not leave you alone. He will guide you through. He will lead you to your destination. He will lead you to the top. He will fight your battle along the way in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Do you know that God wants to lead? He wants to direct. He wants to instruct you in the way to go. He did not want you to follow the way of the devil. Neither did he want you to follow the way of man or follow the way that you think that is good. But he wants to show you his way. He wants to direct you in the way to follow. He wants to teach you what to do. Not only that, he wants to fight you along. He wants to fight for you along the way. Because he has made you apple of his eye. And he's ready to kill and to destroy, as he did for the children of Israel. He's ready to kill even nations in order to sustain you and take you to where he wants you to be. God is ready to waste life. God is ready to waste people. God is ready to destroy whatsoever thing assigned to destroy you. Isaiah 43, verse 3 and 4, explain it better. In Exodus chapter 14, from verse 10 to 16, the Bible makes us understand that God made a way for the children of Israel in the Red Sea. He divided the Great Sea for his people to pass through. He divided the Great Sea for his people to pass through on the dry ground. He created a path for them. Not only that, he also destroyed all their enemies in that same Red Sea. You know, before then, the children of Israel were happy. They thought they have escaped totally from the affliction, torments, everyday torments in the land of Egypt. They thought they are safe forever, and God have delivered them to the hand of Moses. But they did not know that there's something called pursuing Egypt that even pursued them in the way of the Lord. By the time they look back, they saw Pharaoh and the host of Egypt marching closer to them in order to kill and to recapture them. And they were afraid. They were afraid. The Spirit of God said, I should tell you, you that brother, you that sister connected to this broadcast, whatsoever thing that is making you afraid, whatsoever thing that you have seen or you have heard that make you afraid, the Spirit of God said, I should tell you, that you should wait and believe God and you will see the hand of God. God will never commit at the appropriate time. He will manifest himself. He will show himself. He will make a way for you. He will surely make a way for you in the mighty name of Jesus. We all know the rest of the story. How God made the way for his people to pass through. And also adding the heart of Pharaoh and his horsemen to pursue after them. And God destroyed them in the Red Sea. I'm praying for you, your enemy. They will see the hand of God upon your life. And the enemy that are meant for destruction will continue to pursue you until the Lord God destroys them for your sake. In the name of Jesus. In Hebrews chapter 11, verse 30, the Bible makes us understand that by faith, the wall of Jericho fell down flat after they were compassed about for 7 days. Listen to me carefully. I don't know the world erected. I don't know the problem that look as if everything is coming to an end. I don't know the situation you are now, even in foreign land, and it look as if there is no more hope again. You must continue to manage and continue like this. The Spirit of the Lord say, I should tell you, the Lord God that appears suddenly in the lives of his people, in the lives of those that call upon him, he will appear in your life in the name of Jesus. That wall of Jericho that was erected against you suddenly to stop you, to send you back, to kill you and bury you, to stop you in your way to your promised land shall collapse by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. It shall collapse by fire It shall collect the fire. It shall collect the fire in the mighty name of Jesus. God removed the wall of Jericho that was erected to stop his people from entering into the promised land. I decree again by the decree of heaven, whatsoever thing put in place to stop you from enjoying the blessings of God that the Lord God have released into your life, whatsoever thing put in place to stop you not to get to your destination, whatsoever thing put in place to stop you halfway, not to graduate, let the fire of God locate it now and let it be destroyed by fire in the name of Jesus. In 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 13 to 14. 2 Kings chapter 2, 13 and 14. It explains how Elisha, with the mantle of Elijah, smote the river Jordan that want to stop him. And God divided the river for him to pass through. I'm praying for you again. If there is any river of darkness, anything that did not want you to go and exhibit the power of God in your life, whatsoever thing that want to stop you in the wilderness life, that did not want you to manifest for people to see the glory, the blessings of God in your life, power that want to keep you in your father's house, power that say your glory will not rise and shine, I decree by the decree of heaven, wherever they are operating from against you, let fire locate them for destruction now. In the name of Jesus, sound this prayer loud and clear. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Appear in my life. In the name of Jesus. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Appear in my life. Appear in my life. Appear in my life. And divide my Jordan. And divide my Jordan. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Appear in my life in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Acts chapter 12, verse 5, 8, and 10. Acts of Apostles chapter 12, verse 5, and 8 to 10. The Bible says this. Have we seen how God make a way of escape for Peter out of the prison? He sent his angel. Doors and gates were open on their own accord for Peter. I'm praying for someone. If you can shout a loud three amen, the Lord God that opened gates, even the prison gates and the big gates for Peter to escape out of the prison, that same God shall root it out, shall uproot out of your way every gate of ignorance assigned to stop you. In the name of Jesus, any prison, anywhere, aside to cage you down, may link a post to Talia. Let the door of that prison be open for you now in the name of Jesus. In Psalm 105, from verse 17 or from verse 16 to 22. Psalm 105, from 16 to 22. It explained how God sent his word to try and deliver Joseph out of the prison of Pharaoh in Egypt. Before then, the enemy thought that this man that we sold out as a slave, this man that we want to stop, not to fulfill the dreams of his destiny, and we want him to be a slave. He looks as if he's enjoying himself in his master's house. And the enemy have another plan in order to keep him forever and let him be a slave that is enjoying forever. We thank God for the life of Joseph. He understood the relationship that he has with God and he knew his destiny. So he preferred to go to the prison because he knew there is a God that maketh way. And when the word of God came to try him, the king sent for him. Chains that were used to bind his hand and the fetters in his leg was removed. And the king sent for him and made him rulers of his people. I'm praying for you again. As many that are connected to these brothers that are under my voice now, God will arise and he will trouble whosoever that needs to be troubled. He will make a way for you. He will take you to that tall. He will take you to an expected place. He will move you up and promote you by fire in the name of Jesus. In Judges chapter 16, Judges chapter 16, verse 3, the Bible makes us to understand that Samson, with the Spirit of God in him, he took the door together with the gates, not ordinary gates, but the gates of the big city of the land of Philistine. It uprooted it out. So that gate, they lock it up in order to lock him down and in order to capture him. But he rooted it out. Not only that, he carried it to the mountaintop, demonstrating the power and the victory of God. I'm praying for you. Whatsoever thing erected, whatsoever thing put in place to capture you or to destroy the good things of God in your life shall be rooted out by fire in the name of Jesus. I pray for you that the doors and the gates that the enemy have used to lock you up, or the one that they are using to lock up your blessing, to lock up the blessings of God for your life, God shall open it for you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Listen to this. The doors and the gates that the enemy erected to stop you in your way of success shall be rooted out and it shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I want you to understand this, that there are some gates that the enemy will put in place in order to stop you, and that gate need to be rooted out. And there are some other gates that the enemy will put in place in order for you not to enter into your land of blessing, to your place of blessing. That door or that gate need to be opened. I'm praying for you again. The Lord God, with the key of David, that open it and no man can close, and that close and no man can open, shall begin to open unto you every good door that the enemy have closed against you. The door of your blessing, the blessing of sanity, the blessing of children, the blessing of financial breakthrough, the blessing of all what we desire in foreign land, the blessing that will make you known all over the world. Let it be open unto you now in the name of Jesus. I cry against as many that are under my word that the instrument of the enemy, in form the opposite of the enemy, in form of sickness and infirmity, yea, the word of the Lord. It is written that he sent forth his word and healed them and delivered them from the way of destruction. Let that same God that maketh way for his people begin to destroy sickness and infirmity, no matter that, oh Lord, that the enemy have done against your children, and how long it has been afflicting their life. Let there be way of escape now. In the name of Jesus, let sickness and infirmity disappear. Let the healing power of God come upon you now in the name of Jesus. Every yoke of darkness, yoke that say you will not go far, yoke that make you to struggle in foreign land, yoke that want to limit you, yoke that want to compel you to labor hard and to serve another. Make a people sandaye, let a go sandaliadara. Let that yoke now be lifted out of your shoulder in the name of Jesus. Let that yoke be broken and be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Receive your freedom now. Receive your freedom now in the name of Jesus. I pray for that brother. I pray for that sister. The Lord God that maketh way, he will surely make way for you. You will not struggle to serve Jesus. Neither will you suffer in that place that you are. The land of that place that you find yourself as I'm speaking to you now, from the north, south, east, and west, shall release the blessings of God into your life in the name of Jesus, the God that maketh way for his people and led them in the way to go, the God that fed his people, the God that provided water for his people, the God that glorified and manifested himself in life of his people, and their clothes never torn, their leg never swollen. Even for 40 years, I decree by the decree of heaven, that same God from now as I speak, will begin to lead and guide you in the way to follow. In the name of Jesus, you will not make mistakes. You will not fall into hell. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In conclusion, before we pray, I told you there's some prayer that we're going to spend time praying. In conclusion, you want God to make way for you. You want to move without hindrance in the way of God to your destination. And at the end, you want to make a move. You want to know the way maker and the way himself, Jesus Christ. You need to give your life to Jesus. You need to accept him as your Lord and your Savior. And you need to have a living relationship with him. Because David has a living relationship with God. When Goliath wanted to stop him suddenly from moving in the way of God to the palace, he remembered the God that delivered him from the bear, the God that delivered him and make a way of escape from the lion, and he called upon that God. And that God that created heaven and the earth, that maketh way where there's no way, manifested himself in his life. The sword of Goliath that he had been boasting, that he had boasted that we used to cut off the head of David, was used to cut off his own head. I pray for you again. That instrument that the enemy has prepared to cage you, to bring you down, shall be used for you to escape. Not only that, and to kill and destroy all your enemies in the name of Jesus. The last one is you need to cry for the way maker to make a way for you. You need to cry unto him. Say, God, make a way for me. I'm tired of following my own way. I'm tired of following the way of people. Make a way of escape for me. Show me the way. Direct me in the way to follow. Let's close our eyes at this junction and begin to confess our sin and begin to talk to God. Let's ask for forgiveness as we confess our sins. Let us tell him that we are sorry. Let's confess our fault and our mistakes before the Lord. Let's cry for his mercy, that he should have mercy upon us, that he should deliver us, that he should make way of escape for us, that he should direct us in the way to go. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to sing this song along with me as we prepare to enter to the concluding prayer session, which I want us to pray with all the power we can gather. And we're going to spend time to pray. My God, we make our way where there seems to be no way. He walks the way we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me close into inside with love and strength for each new day. He will make a way. He will make a way. God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He walks the way we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me close into inside with love and strength for each new day. He will make a way. He will make a way with love and strength for each new day. He will make a way. We may shout this loud and clear. Jesus, you are the way, the truth, and the life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lord Jesus, my Savior, you are the way, the truth, and the life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. In the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, my Savior, you are the way, the truth, and the life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. Lead and guide me in my journey of life. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Before we continue, listen to this. A brother had a revelation. And in that revelation, he saw himself. And he was contemplating within himself. That God, show me your way. I don't want to follow my way again. Show me the way that I need to follow that will take me to heaven. And he heard the Spirit of God says, if you are in him and he is in you, you will see the way. And the brother said, I'm in him. And I know that Jesus is in me. And he heard the voice of the Spirit of God again say, open your eyes very well. And he saw a big ray of light beside him. And his spirit said, enter. Immediately he entered, listen carefully. He discovered that he's no more in control of himself. The power of the light is the one that's moving him up and down. According to the brother, just sometimes we're moving with fast speed, and the light passed through a rock, and he would be afraid that he's going to smash himself on the rock and die. But he discovered that he passed through the rock as someone passing through the air. Close your eyes again and pray this prayer. Oh God, my Father, lead me in your way. Take control of my life now. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, lead me in your way. Take control of my life. 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 Begin to direct me. Begin to instruct me. Begin to guide me. In the name of Jesus. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The next prayer. Shout it loud and clear. Oh God, my Father, make way for me in this land. I don't know the land you want. I don't know the place. I know that I'm in the land of Nigeria. and God will make way for me. So he mentioned that place. Oh God, my Father, make way for me in this land of Nigeria, in this land of Ibadan. Don't put Ibadan, put your own land there. Oh God, my Father, make way for me in this land. Make way for me in this land. Make way for me in this land. I must prosper. I must make it. I must move forward in life. Enough is enough. The power will not stop me in this land. In the name of Jesus, Pastor will not stop me in this land. In the name of Jesus, the Lord God that bless and prosper Joseph in foreign land. The Lord God that bless and prosper Daniel in foreign land. He shall bless you. He shall prosper you. He shall move you forward. Mi kapiliye, robo si kapiliya, na gabo liya gabo, mi lekeye gabo liya sindaliya. Oh God, my Father, make way for me. Make way for me. And prosper me in this land. In this land. In this land. Prosper my soul. 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 In the name of Jesus. Prosper my soul. In the name of Jesus, prosper my soul. In the name of Jesus, prosper my soul. In the name of Jesus, prosper my soul. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. My soul, magnify the Lord. My spirit, praise his name. For death could not hold him captive, even in the grave. Jesus is Lord, for death could not hold him captive, even in the grave. Jesus is Lord. I speak the word of God, the word of power, the word of fire, the word that is, the word that delivers, the word that sets free, the word of solution. As many that are connected to this program, that are under my voice now. My liberia sitaye, the power of grace cannot hold you in captive. In the name of Jesus, if there's anything of you buried in order to get your glory, let it at fire now. In the name of Jesus. My lesi taboria shandalia. Le kapilie zumalia kabosutolie. Le shende bora gabosutolia. The date of the grave, the gates of the enemy in the grave shall not hold down your blessings. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Number three, shout this louder and with more anger in your hearts. Every obstacle, wall of darkness assigned to slow me down, assigned to stop me suddenly, clear away by fire. Clear away by fire. Every obstacle, wall of darkness in any form, in any way, assigned to slow me down, assigned to delay good things in my life, assigned to stop me, clear away by fire. Clear away by fire. Clear away by fire. Clear the way 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 by fire. Clear the way. 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 Clear the way by fire. In the name of Jesus. Clear the way by fire. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I pray for that sister. And I'm also praying for that brother. Whatsoever thing programmed into your life, whatsoever thing assigned in your way to stop you, to delay good things from manifesting in your life, to steal from your destiny, let the fire of God locate it now and let it be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every attack from the home against you in that foreign land, let it backfire in the name of Jesus. Every dream of emotion, dream of stagnancy, dream of seeing yourself in the former places, may let the power behind that dream, Catch fire now in the name of Jesus. That the enemy has spoken, that they are put in place against you, will not stand. It will not prosper. It shall backfire in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Shout the next prayer. Oh God, that maketh way for Daniel in foreign land. Oh God, that maketh way and prosper Joseph in foreign land. Make a way for me and prosper my life in this place. In this place. In this place. Oh God, that maketh way and prosper Daniel in foreign land. Oh God, that maketh way and prosper Joseph in foreign land. Make a way for me and prosper my soul in this place. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Oh God, my Father, you are the God that maketh way and prosper for Daniel and prosper him in foreign land. You are the God that maketh way for Joseph and prosper him in foreign land. Make way for your people. Make way for your people and prosper them, and prosper them, and prosper them, and prosper them. In the name of Jesus, make way for them and prosper them. Make a way for them and prosper them. Make 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 way for them and prosper them. In the name of Jesus, nothing, even the law of that country shall not stop you. In the name of Jesus, God will make a way for you. God will strengthen you. God will fight for you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, my likabosutaniye, lebora kabosutolia, my lisandaye kabosutolia, that need to come to pass, that need to come to place, even for you to be exalted, to be lifted up, to be promoted, to move from the level that you are now to your next level. Let it happen in that land for your sake. In the name of Jesus, my likabosutolia. I'm praying for someone. If your amen can be powerful, that will promote you, that will exhibit the grace, the blessings of God in your life. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. That people will prefer in your life. And they will pay money for the idea that will solve problems of men. Receive it in the name of Jesus. In that area of your business, in that area of the work in your heart, Malika Basandaye, let there be prosperity. Let there be lifting up. 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 In the name of Jesus. I pray for that sister. You will not collect to lose again. In the name of Jesus, power that will make you to lose again. Let the power die. In the name of Jesus, every dream, bless it again, that the enemy has been using, even to steal from you. Let the power behind the dream, together with the dream, die now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. The next prayer, shout it louder than before. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and divide my children. Where is the God of Elijah? I don't know your Jordan. You know it. You know that thing that just suffered suddenly. Even though you have passed through it before, but it's not by your own power. And it resurfaces again in order to stop you. You need to shout and cry unto the Lord. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise in this my situation and deliver me. Show me your way of escape. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise in this my situation and deliver me. And deliver me. Make a way for me. Make a way for me. Divide my Jordan. Divide my Jordan. Remove the problem out of my life. In the name of Jesus. 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 In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, oh God, arise in my situation now. My God, my Father, arise in my situation. In the name of Jesus, Malekabo, Rigabasitahe, Bilikabo, Liasandadia, in the name of Jesus, 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 in Jesus' mighty name we pray. I'm praying for you. If your amen can be powerful, every sudden problem that suffers suddenly in your life, in your marriage, that suffering suddenly against you. Let the God of Elijah make a way for you now in the name of Jesus. Let the God that parted the river and make Elisha to walk on the dry ground. Let that same God make way for you now as I speak in the name of Jesus. Your ears shall hear good news. Your eyes shall see the falling down and the open disgrace of the enemy that conspire against you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. The next prayer. Oh God, my Father. Oh God, that make way for his people in the great sea, make way for me. Make way for me in my working place. Make way for me. Make way for me in this country. Make way for me in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, make way for me, 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 in the name of Jesus, make way for me, in the name of Jesus, make way for me, in the name of Jesus, make way for me, in the name of Jesus, make way for me, in the name of Jesus, make way for me, in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I'm praying for your people, young and old, male and female, that are connected to the broadcast. I decree by the decree of him, the mighty one of Israel, the man of war, the Lord of hosts, that maketh way in the great sea, shall make way for you. In the name of Jesus. Pursuing power that have been pursuing you in your way of success shall die suddenly in the name of Jesus. God will arise in your life. He will arise in your family to defend his interest in your life in the name of Jesus. When the enemy say and announce, cast it down, God will announce and release, lifting up unto you. In the name of Jesus, there shall be noises of joy in your house. In the name of Jesus, testimony upon testimony that begin to manifest, even your desired testimony, testimony that will bring people to gather and say, I want to know the God that has done this and I want to serve that God. God will begin to work it out in your life in the name of Jesus. If there is anything assigned to trouble you in the day, anything assigned to trouble you in the night, anything assigned to trouble you in the sleep, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, before the day that thing shall die, even before the night and before you sleep, they shall catch fire in the name of Jesus. I ask in the name of Jesus for the wisdom of God that will make you to be wiser than your enemies. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. The Lord bless you. The Lord increase you and do wonders in your life. In the name of Jesus. The Lord promote you. The Lord satisfy you with long life, with sound health. The Lord set you and establish you, even in foreign land, in the name of Jesus. Whatsoever thing, either from your father's house or your mother's house, whatsoever thing from your past life, saying no to the blessings of God in your life, I command it to catch fire now in the name of Jesus. It is well with your soul. Pray this last prayer and pray it with all the power that you can carry. Every evil gate assigned to stop me in this country, be rooted out. Any evil door closed against me in this country, open now by fire. Talking of the door of your blessing, the door of sounded of joy, the door of your next level, the door of the document needed, the door of the job that you desire, the door that will open and push you to high places. Oh God, my Father, let every evil door, evil gates, assigned to stop me in this country, be rooted out. Let it 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 be rooted out. In the name of Jesus, let it be rooted out. 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 In the name of Jesus, let it be rooted out. 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 In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I cover you all with the blood of Jesus. I cover you in your way with the blood of Jesus. I decree the presence, the power, fire of God upon your life. In the name of Jesus, you will not let me say. You will not follow the wrong way of life. In the name of Jesus, the enemy will not push you to places that you do not want. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. 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 Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. God bless you, sir. God bless you. God bless you. God of heaven and earth, we honor you in the mighty name of Jesus. God of heaven and earth, God that has called you, that God will continue to back you up, sir, in the mighty name of Jesus. People of God, please, I beg you in the name of Jesus, let's begin to lift up our Father in the Lord into the hand of the mighty God that has called him. Virtue has gone out of him this hour. Let's begin to ask God to refill him by the power that is in the name of Jesus. The battle of who sent you concerning tonight's ministration, concerning tonight's message, concerning tonight's prayers, by the authority that is in the name of Jesus, God will arise and he will scatter that battle in the mighty name of Jesus. Any power that wants to touch your household, the God of heaven and earth shall waste them in the mighty name of Jesus. You have started well and you will finish well by the power that is in the name of Jesus. You shall not be put to shame. You will go from glory to glory in the mighty name of Jesus. And so shall it be in Jesus' mighty and wonderful name, we pray. Amen. God bless you, sir. God of heaven and earth, we honor you. We are wonderfully blessed. And I know that the God, the way maker, that God will equally make a way for you in the mighty name of Jesus. He that has started well with you is a God that never abandoned his home. He will not abandon you in the mighty name of Jesus. We appreciate you. God will bless you in Jesus' name. Thank you, my SRO. God will honor you in Jesus' name. People of God, we bless the name of the Lord for this second day. And it's an awesome time in the presence of the Most High God. And I'm sure that tomorrow is another day. And I believe God, and I believe God, and I believe God with you. Believe God for myself that by the mercies of Jehovah, we shall all testify in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's begin to bless God for today. Let's appreciate him. Let's thank him. Let's honor him for what he has done. Let's honor him for his faithfulness in our life. Let's appreciate this great God. Father, we bless you. Father, we honor you. Father, we adore you. We say, blessed be thy holy name. Receive all of our praises. Receive all of our honor. Thank you, Father, for your servant. Thank you, Father, for the word that has gone forth. Thank you, Father, for the impartation. Thank you, Father, for that which you have done, and all glory shall be unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty and wonderful name we pray. Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. People of God, God of heaven and earth, we honor you in the mighty name of Jesus. It is time now to give our substance unto the Lord as God has laid it into your spirit, man, to give unto this program. I want you to please give generously, and God of heaven and earth will bless you for that in the mighty name of Jesus. The accounts of the church will be put on screen now, and I want you to avail of that opportunity and give your offering. Let us pray over those offerings. Father, we want to thank you for your faithfulness. I want to thank you, Father, because we know that we cannot give to buy or to pay for all that you have done unto us. We are only giving a sacrificial offering to bless your holy name for what you have done. Father, we say, receive it from us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the dew of heaven come upon this offering in the mighty name of Jesus. And to you alone shall be all glory, all honor, and all adoration in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father, for in Jesus' mighty and wonderful name we have prayed. Amen, amen, amen in Jesus' name. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's take some few minutes to do the transfer that any one of us wants to do. And God will bless you for that. In Jesus' name, amen. Father. Father, we want to appreciate you and we want to bless your holy name. Father, we know that in your faithfulness, you are God forevermore. And we know that tomorrow, even as we come before you once again, Lord, it shall be bundle of testimony and it shall be mighty encounter before your holy presence. Accept our thanks and praises, Jehovah God, for in Jesus' mighty and wonderful. People of God, by the grace of God, tomorrow is the last day, and our Father in the Lord, the AGO in charge of MFM Africa, in the person of Pastor Lawrence Olasende, will be ministering unto us. And I know that the God of heaven and earth has prepared him for that program. So I will encourage you, please, I beg you, God in his faithfulness is awaiting you in the mighty name of Jesus. And do not forget that tonight, by 9 p.m., we are going equally into our Bible reading and exposition. And by the grace of God, tonight, we are reading Numbers chapter 23, 24, and 25. And our prayer quick for tonight is killing the seed of darkness. And I encourage you to join. We can never overpray. We can only underpray. And as we pray these prayers, the faithfulness of God, we perfect that which concerneth you and concerneth me in Jesus' name. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Now we are going to share the grace and believe God for His glory to begin to perfect that which concerns you and to begin to manifest powerfully in your life and in your destiny. In Jesus' name, praise the name of the Lord. Endeavor to remind someone about this program, and God will bless you for that in Jesus' name. Let us share the grace together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. For what God has done, for what he will do, and for his faithfulness, and for who he is, let us shout seven Jericho test provoking hallelujah. Let's go. Hallelujah. 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 God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen in Jesus' name. God bless you. Good night, people of God. Good night. God bless you.
Promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God.
worship you. Oh,